But it's not just the tech natural gas linkage. This market is full of absurdity, and it's very upsetting. I'm going to give you another one. Warby Parker came public today. This is a vertically integrated eyeglass maker with a digital footprint and a bunch of brick-and-mortar stores. I talked about it last night. I think it's a good company. It's not a great company. I told you not to touch the stock above its reference price of $40 because the valuation would just be impossible to justify, if not silly. In part, that's because Warby Parker did a direct listing, meaning it just plopped down on the exchange to fare for itself. And in this case, they don't even have a lockup on insider selling. But today, the stock instantly jumps to 54. It's got a $6 billion valuation. That's lunacy, people. Last year, Warby Parker raised a bunch of money at $3 billion, and almost nothing has changed since then. So either the people who got in on that last round of private fundraising are some of the savviest investors in the world, or the people buying it up here today are a bunch of suckers. I'm guessing the latter. Of course, this is not unusual. About 5 years ago, I had a cup of coffee at a place called Dutch Bro in Ashland, Oregon, where my daughter was living at the time. Everybody loves Dutch Bro out there. They got these kiosks and parking lots, and somehow they remember your drink from month to month. When the company came public 2 weeks ago, the IPO priced at $23. Then the stock opened at $32.50, up 41%, for surging nearly $55 over the next couple of days. Since then, Dutch Bro has settled down in the mid-40s, $7.3 billion valuation. At least it's actually profitable, unlike Warby Parker. I know, adjusted, they're profitable. Give me a break. Again, Dutch Bro is being valued not by its prospects, okay, but by the taste of its coffee and the fun of the kiosk. I doubt anyone involved in this deal from the banking end has a clue how to explain why this stock should trade where it does. It makes no sense.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.